Good to see you here. Today we're talking about how you can bring out the sky in Adobe Lightroom. I'm pretty sure you have taken photos in a scattered or even an overcast day, and the sky just wasn't really cooperating. It just don't look very nice in the photo. It's all blown out. There's no details, no texture in the sky. You can't even really see the cloud in your photos as well. This happens to me all the time, and we're gonna fix that in Adobe Lightroom with a few tweaks. And I'll show you guys the tools that I use to bring the sky out. Make it moody, make it dramatic, make them visible again so they're not just sitting there at the corner shying away from the audience. Everything is beautiful. If you don't see it, look harder. And I'm off topic here. So sky, let's make them moody, make them dramatic. I would recommend to shooting raw so there's more info and details that you can work with in post. But if you didn't shooting raw, that's okay too. The tweaks I'm about to show you guys will work too. I got a few photos here that we can play around with. I snapped this photo about a year ago in Taiwan, and it was raining, overcast day. You can still see a bit of a cloud here, but not too much. This won't be a perfect first example here. So the first thing we want to do in Adobe Lightroom is to drag this gradient filter. You want to select that first and then just drag it across. Place it around the horizon where it separates the sky and the landscape, or it depends on your photo, of course. But for this example, let's just put it here for now, demonstration purpose. The next thing we want to do is to drag down the exposure and see how much more information we can get by doing that. Okay, let's not make it too dark. Quick tip when you're using Adobe Lightroom, if you're not sure about what you will get with the slider, just drag them all the way to the end and see how much it'll change the photo, and you'll know exactly where and how it's gonna change it. Let's put this back. So we have the exposure down a little bit now with more details in the sky. Let's pull it down a little bit more, like so. And then we'll fix that later according to the whole picture, of course. So the next thing we're gonna adjust is the shadow and see how much it gives us. Okay, that's not too bad. Let's keep it here for now. Go to the blacks. As you see, it really brings out the dark part of the cloud. Okay, let's leave this at negative 26 here for now. And the biggest change I want to show you here is the dehaze. That's gonna change the cloud dramatically. Check this out. If you pull this up, you can see how much we can change by just pulling the dehaze all the way up. If you pull all the way down, it's gonna look all blown out. So let's add this in here. By bringing up the dehaze, we'll bring up the sky more with more contrast and depth in it. We can also bring up the clarity here too. This will help bring out the texture and details of the sky a little bit more, because clarity darkens the area that has more contrast in it. So these are the five main settings that you can adjust and play around with to bring your sky out more. Just drag down your exposure a little bit and see where you can go with the information in there, and play around with the shadows, play around with the blacks. These two are like micro adjustment. The biggest one would be the dehaze, but don't go too crazy with the dehaze because it's gonna look very unnatural in a way. And also adjust clarity accordingly, because that'll darken the area in the image that has more contrast in it. So every photo is different. If you put the same input to your photo, it's definitely not gonna look the same or the way you want it. And especially these input right here is just for example. I'm not actually gonna use those edit on this photo. Now to make it a bit more moody and dramatic, we can go to the HSL slider here and play with the blue here. Let's go ahead and desaturate the blue since it would look weird and doesn't make sense if I go the other way. So let's pull it down. Let's go to luminous and drag down the blue, which will change the tone of the sky in a totally different way. If we pull all the way down at the end or all the way up, and you'll see the drastic change it makes. There's one more tip I want to show you guys here with the HSL slider. You see that dot on the left top corner here? If you're not sure which color you're changing or adjusting, you can always just select this dot and just pick a color on the image, and it'll show you what you're changing right now by dragging it up and down. So right now I'm adjusting the aqua and the blue all together. This way you can really fine tune the HSL slider without adjusting all the other ones that's not necessary in this case. So as you see, we have a huge problem with this image because there's mountains on the side and kind of caves in right in the middle of the image. And with the gradient filter, it doesn't cover all the part that I want to adjust in this photo. Other than using the gradient filter, we can also use the adjustment brush in this case to bring out the sky. Let's go ahead and delete this gradient filter. So we can adjust the brush size here and brush through the sky like so. Now you don't see anything here because I don't have the selected mask overlay on. You can press O to toggle it on. So you want to have that selected mask overlay on to know which part of the image I have painted with the adjustment brush. Okay, a little trick I like to use here while using the adjustment brush is to hold on Command or Control on PC. This way Lightroom will try its best to mask along the line and edges for you. It doesn't work 100% of the time, but it's definitely faster than brushing through the image manually. If there's anything out of place, you can just press Option and then erase it like this. A big advantage about using the adjustment brush is that we can brush through the specific place that we want to adjust. Okay, let me use a different image. I have a few more here that we can play around with. So, for example, if we just want this part of the sky, maybe a bit over here as well. Okay, and then toggle O to see where we have brushed. Okay, that's pretty nasty, but so see, toggling on the selected mask is very useful here because we can actually see which part of the image we have selected. This way we can just focus on a certain part of the image that we want to adjust. Here's another tool that we can use if we happen to have an image like this. So as you see, it's kind of hard to apply a gradient filter like this on the sky. So let's go ahead and apply one just for demonstration purpose here. Let's do here. It actually goes into the monument. Let's make it more drastic. Okay, this is crazy, right? The monument is like dark, you can't see anything, which is what we don't want because we don't want the monument to be like covered in the gradient filter. We can go to the luminance in range mask to ease that gradient filter effect to the monument. At the same time, we'll press Option. You can drag up the range all the way up, and then as you see, kind of ease off on the monument itself, but at the same time it still have that effect applied on the sky. I've probably just used the adjustment brush in this case with the monument, but it's always good to know the options that you have. So play around with your photos, use the tools that I just showed you. Drag down the exposure, play around with the shadow, the blacks, and then really drag up the dehaze, not too high to the point where it's kind of too crazy. Add a bit of clarity if you want. Also desaturate the blue in the HSL and the luminance to make it more moody and dramatic. I feel like adjusting the blue in the HSL slider really changed the mood of the whole image by a lot. Alright, go out and take photos. Bring those sky out and make them pop. I hope you guys liked today's Adobe Lightroom tutorial. As usual, don't forget to like, subscribe, and ring the bell on your way out. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you guys in the next one.